if we don't aspire to what's realistic, I think we always have a sense of failure. And this is of big concern to me, because I really feel like this is becoming a little bit of an epidemic. And if you are you and you're totally unique, well, then you are what I like to call a snowflake. There is nobody like you. So if you are busy comparing yourself to an unrealistic standard of beauty, what hope do you have of actually dressing yourself? The bigger issue here is that what this really means is that we don't have to not love fashion and beauty, right? I want all of you to love style. I want all of you to love shopping and expressing yourselves. But what I want and what I hope for is that instead of using Giselle or anybody else or Reese Witherspoon or Natalie Portman, even when she's not preggers, as your aspiration, that you start with yourself, that you use your raw material and the fact that you are all snowflakes to realize that there is nobody comparable to you, not on any level, really. And the problem is that based on modern advertising that's taken these ideas of sort of, you know, genetic predisposition and the things that we find attractive in other human beings to an extreme, so now thinness is anorexia, right? And all of these things where these girls look like they've been stretched on a rack from the age of like 7 on. There are a zillion reasons we lose sight of who we are. When you are battling for your life, you are not thinking about your hair color, if you have hair. You know, when you age, you start to worry about the fact that youth is prized in this culture beyond all else. We gain weight for a zillion reasons, and we think we're not good enough because all we see around us are thin people, right? Okay. There is a reason to start with you, because that is how you are going to figure out exactly what you should look like and what you want to say to the world. So I would love to have somebody come up here and yes themselves to death in front of the mirror. And then I'm going to do the and part. Now, what I like about this is that this is actually very good because you seem to have a pretty healthy body image.
Yeah, I'm okay with it.
She's okay with it. Now, listen, I'm not going to lie. I'm better with my body image than I was when I was, let's say, 25.
Me too.
Right? You too. Okay, so this is another thing. Look, with age comes experience. Like, thank God, it has to come with something. You know, so this is my point. It does matter what stage of life you're in. And in a lot of ways, I do feel like this kind of conversation needs to be had with all of our young girls, whether they're our daughters, our nieces, our friends, whatever, and my tweeps in particular. I feel very, very strongly that young girls are not being instilled with enough of a sense of self-esteem. And it takes women like you to be able to kind of take them through this and say there is light at the end of the tunnel and you do need to accept yourself. I want them to start accepting themselves right now, as early as possible, so that I can get somebody younger up here who would say, yeah, I've struggled, but I'm there. I get it. I love who I am.